Okay. Let's go. All right. In past videos, you know that I had always preached about staying away from processed foods. And if we're going to be on the journey of intermittent fasting and living the fasting lifestyle, then we want to counteract those issues of what? Inflammation. We want to be in good health. We have to go against the grain and to combat the inflammation that's already in our body. You know, inflammation can be good or bad. On one hand, it helps your body to attack illnesses or disease or injuries. If there's a chronic inflammation, then it can lead to what? Weight gain. It can deal with a chronic disease such as autoimmune diseases. And that is why I am on the intermittent fasting lifestyle. The healthy habits that I adopted are, for instance, having a tight eating window. I do a 2-hour eating window. I eat 1 meal a day and I fast for 22 hours a day. You got to make it count for that 1 meal, right? You know, you got one shot to get it right by eating the proper foods. And so I love to share with you the foods that I consider anti-inflammatory and that will help combat the inflammation that we fight in our body. With that 1 meal a day, you guys have seen in my past videos, such as what I eat in a day on OMAD, and that dish in itself was my warm spinach tuna salad, and it has pretty much all the items that I was going to mention today. One is spinach, and spinach is amazing in itself. So that is, and green vegetables other than just spinach. The foods I eat every week and I continue as much as possible is some very specific foods that are considered anti-inflammatory. And that is why I really, really appreciate the bonus that you get on top of eating real good food in general. I also love fish. So fish is considered anti-inflammatory. Now, in the tuna salad, tuna is not specifically noted in studies that I've seen, but it is noted that salmon is a great source to help you with combating those issues that we have in our gut. The tomatoes is an excellent fruit as well, a very good item to choose if you can add that into your meals on a weekly basis, you know, maybe one or two times. That's certainly a great fruit to choose. And then if you want to go on the sweeter side, I do eat berries and grapes occasionally. I don't always get it in every week, but these are fruits that I do suggest, you know, like the blackberries or the raspberries or the grapes. Definitely an anti-inflammatory food. And especially green tea is one of my favorites, and I try to have it almost every day. It safeguards your cells from the damage that inflammation would do that can lead to disease. So drink some tea. It's a good thing. I also forgot to mention that dark chocolate is very good and considered anti-inflammatory. And so if you are eating at least what they consider 70% cocoa, that is an excellent source of antioxidants that would really help combat what you're doing. Now, that doesn't mean that we eat excessive amounts every day. It can reduce the inflammation. So they may also reduce the risk of several diseases as well. So it has excellent minerals. And that's why we can find so many natural ways of combating any kind of disease that's out there. Now, it's not the all to end all. It's not going to be just the magic pill. Nevertheless, it's doing it natural. And if you're eating every day or at least a meal a day, you should make the best of it of eating the right food. Now, the foods that I consider anti-inflammatory are spinach, green tea, tomatoes, avocados, berries, grapes, and salmon. And all those items I eat on a weekly basis. On the flip side of things, you know those foods that are the wrong things to eat. Now, if you want to have a little bit, I understand it. But that's why we need to stay away from processed foods. A lot of those foods that cause inflammation would be sugar and high fructose corn syrup, artificial trans fat, vegetables and seed oils, refined carbohydrates, not the carbs that we talked about before, but the refined ones, again, processed, excessive alcohol. You can still have the occasional cocktail or a glass of wine, but it really shouldn't be more than one a day for women and maybe two a day for men. And I only do probably two over the weekend. That's kind of it, because I'm getting to the point where I'm really going away from alcohol. Not just yet, but I'm going away soon. And of course, processed meat. So again, processed foods, process. No good. Everything here I just named, and it's not coming from the ground, nature of some sort, and it's going through some mill, and it's being manipulated, and where you get the GMOs. I would stay away from these foods, and you will be in good hands when you eat the other foods that are anti-inflammatory. Question: what type of anti-inflammatory foods are you adopting into a healthy habit in your daily schedule of eating? I'd love to know. So please leave a comment below. And guys, don't forget, if you're watching this and you haven't been on my channel before, please do subscribe. It really does help the channel grow. And give me a thumbs up if you like these type of videos. And if it's something that you want to see me tackle in a subject matter that's pertaining to fasting, healthy habits, happiness, any of those subject matters, please do leave a comment as well. I really appreciate you guys, and I thank you for watching. And don't forget, caregiving begins with you.